Okay, this is the third part in the load store instruction. Okay, that is swap instruction. In my previous classes, I had explained single register load store instruction, multiple register load store instruction, and now I am explaining swap. Okay, how to swap data, right? So swap instruction, what exactly it does? So it allows to swap right content of a memory with content of a register, right? Content of a memory, interchange the values. Okay, you give an address, from that memory address, whatever the value is there, it will come to a particular register, and the register value will go back and store in the memory at that particular address, just exchanging the 32-bit value between a register and a memory. Okay, now this instruction is very atomic operation. Okay, this instruction is an atomic operation. That means as long as the swap instruction, when you execute that instruction, gets completed. Okay, so bus cannot be used by any other instruction. Okay, so it prevents any other instruction from reading or writing using your data bus in the ARM processor. So when ARM processor executes swap instruction, okay, no other instruction can use your data bus, okay, bus in the ARM. Okay, there's one more thing, it's called hold bus. Again, hold bus in the sense, very simple concept, when swap instruction is getting executed, as long as swap instruction gets executed, no other instruction can make use of that bus. All other instructions are prevented by using the data bus. So it's called hold the bus. This instruction holds the bus, okay, as long as this instruction gets executed. So swap is very simple concept, interchange data between a register and a memory, 32-bit data. Now instruction is, there are two types of swap instruction, SWP and SWPB. Okay, swap byte or swap entire word, 32-bit word. Okay, so that optional they are talking here, that option right here. B means byte. It's optional. If you write SWP, you can swap a 32-bit data. If you write SWPB, you can swap only one byte between register and a memory location. Then very interesting thing, so this is the address, how last operation here, we mentioned the address of the memory from which we have to swap the data, right? That is the address, we store it in a register and use it as a register indirect addressing. Then two registers, together here we require three registers, right? In higher level language, we swap between two variables. Now here we need three registers. That why? Because, see, that's very interesting here in ARM. Okay, let's study swap. Okay, swap instruction. RD, RM, RN, you know by now what is RN. RN will hold address of the memory from which we have to swap. So how exactly? See, whatever the RN you have mentioned, that memory data will be placed in some temporary place, will be copied to some temporary place. Okay, from the memory address mentioned in RN. Okay, temporary memory. Then whatever the RM value, right, RM value is placed in that memory address, right, that memory address, and whatever the temporary value we have copied, right, from the memory, that is, will be copied to RD, right? If you don't get, I'll explain very simple concepts. Okay, I'll explain. RN holds the address of the memory, from that memory 32-bit word data will be copied to RM, data will be copied to RM, and 32-bit data from the register, one more register will get stored in that particular memory, that particular memory. So it is not exactly swap between one single register and one memory, right? It is a swap between two registers and one memory. Okay, so memory data will go to the one register and data from another register will get stored in the that particular memory. Okay, a byte has the same concept. Byte means it is only 8-bit. Okay, instead of 32 bits, we copy only 8-bit. But ultimately, it is not exactly the swap. Okay, it is not swap like RM data go and sit in the memory and memory data will come back to RM. No. Okay, so here it is completely different. RM data, second operand register data, will go and sit in the memory addressed by RN register, and from that same memory, data will get copied to RD. Okay, RD register. Remember this. This is what called swap. Okay, this what is called swap. So after swap, your RM remains same, only RD will be uploaded by the memory data. Okay, so again, always remember this. Okay, how exactly swap works. Okay, here one example is given. Here example is given. Look at, this is a memory address at 9000 is the address, and this is a 32-bit data in that 9000 address, right? Starting from the 9000. Okay, look at my, before executing the swap instruction, look at the values of R0, R1, R2. Now what happens? The content of R2 is considered as address, right? That is 9000 is address. From the 9000 address, whatever the 32-bit value is there, it will be copied to R1, right? Some temporary variable. Okay, I'll again explain this. Okay, it's very simple concept. Ultimately, after execution, R2 content from memory address R2 will be copied to R1. Whatever the content of R1 will be copied to the memory address mentioned by R2, and whatever the data is there in that memory will be copied to R0. Okay, this is what I told you, right? Exactly, look at this. What is R2? 9000, right? So you know, whatever the R1 value is there, it will be copied to the memory mentioned by R2 register, right? And memory mentioned by R2 register will get copied to R0. Okay, in between there is a temporary location it uses to swap.